400 years after Tiber Septim's reign, the beginning will meet the end, and the bloody circle will close in the Empire of Tamriel. The unworthy heirs of the Septim dynasty have allowed the bonds of the Empire to weaken and crack. Uriel Septim VII cannot repair what his ancestors ignored. The provinces fight among themselves like neglected children, drunk with rebellion, and one indomitable power hides itself, but not forever.
Excuse the gloom, but none may know of this meeting. The nature of my trouble is darker still. Over a year ago, King Lysandus of Daggerfall died honorably on the field of battle. He was as loyal a subject, ally, and friend as you are. I did grieve for him, but his spirit does not rest. With a spectral army, he haunts his former kingdom, crying for revenge. I do not know why a good and loyal man would be so cursed. Perhaps you can find the answer and close the marble jaws of oblivion, bringing peace to his soul. I ask this as your emperor and your friend. I have one lesser request. Several years ago, I wrote a letter to the Queen of Daggerfall. It never arrived. The letter was of a sentimental and personal nature. If you find and destroy that letter, I will be grateful. Now, my champion, rest well this night, for tomorrow you sail for the kingdom of Daggerfall.
You wake and look around the room. Some hours ago, you were in the boat en route to Daggerfall when a storm of supernatural strength boiled over the Illiac Bay like a malefic creature. Your boat was destroyed, but you managed to swim through the churning water to a promontory rock. There you found a cave and escaped the fury of the storm. You had only just lit a small fire when a mudslide sealed you within. Your fear of being buried alive calmed when you saw the corridor leading out of the cavern. Perhaps there is a way out of this cave after all. Once free of the cave, you can begin the Emperor's Quest. That can be active during the game. It runs throughout the first dungeon for a short time, and for a short time afterward, do you want to use this tutorial? Though I already pretty much know how to play this game. So right off the bat, you can tell that the game looks significantly different. And yeah, I just wanted to show you guys how this game looks. There's like fog and stuff right there. I don't know if this is what the original dungeon looked like in the original game, but yeah, that was way too pixelated for you to ever know the difference. Now, I would like to go ahead and equip stuff onto my character. that's chain quitters. Iron longsword. We can definitely use this, but alright, how do you feel wearing a woman's quitters on your body there? Alright, magic items, a spellbook. Now, shock, greeling, and slow falling. Alright. Okay, touch range, shock based, and icon. And this would be, well, caster only, chameleon, normal. I'm not sure what that is, slow fall. Caster only, of course. Chameleon probably helps you disguise better. I'll go ahead and add this to hotkey 2 and add this to hotkey. Excuse me? Yeah. Yeah, hard to keep on. You cannot... Excuse me, why are the casual... excuse me, the... Yes. Yes, that is what I want to add to... Ebony Dagger, right. That is what I wanted to add to hotkey number one. Not the casual pants. This guy looks... Yeah, he doesn't even have any boots to wear right now. Holy shit, this piece is dark. There's a door here, and there's probably a rat here as well. There's supposed to be one. Where is it? Right there. Oh right, I forgot that it's thrust based. The rat is dead. Rat has led to the bestiary. So I've got a bestiary now. Which... holy shit, that's something else altogether. And yeah. Certain animals carry a disease, no special materials are required to harm them. Right, giant rat. It will tell you like... Yeah, basically... all of this. Will give you like loads of information about these. Loot pile, gold pieces 41. And potion recipe. I wonder what this potion recipe is. Orc strength. Okay, let us go ahead and keep this in our inventory. We are already being a little heavy. I'll rest until fully rested. And first of all, I'm going to save the game here. And I'm going to call it save one. Now, I can actually go ahead and carry these lights. Or maybe I can like douse them. Or so I'd heard. I don't know. Yeah, not working. I installed darker dungeons to be able to douse out lights, but for whatever reason it's not really working. Maybe that light will work. I'm still trying to... douse light, like swing the old Daggerfall way. We're gonna run past that because there's like an imp in there. I do not really want to tackle that in. Or maybe we can try. Maybe we can try. We do have an ebony dagger, so maybe we can try. That hit hard. Why the fuck are you running away, son? Imp has been added to the bestiary. Oh hey, you've got some gold and a small scorpion stinger. That'll definitely be useful to me for later. Gold pieces, 80 gold pieces. I'm getting rich. So dungeon diving actually helps you get rich a lot. I've been healed. And let us go ahead and save the game over onto save 2. This is like the enhanced lighting feature. Okay, so every time you come near these lights, they'll light up. Yeah, I don't think I want to go down there. Not all places are meant to be gone into. You should rest on what you have learned about stealth. Now that... giant bat just died. Let's rest. So, you notice, if you notice probably, I was able to... Perhaps it's time to reflect on what you've learned about critical striking. Oh yes, this guy right here. Arch is dead. That's nice. Hell no, this is the kind of... Oh, maybe I can. Maybe I can equip it. I can actually, that is amazing, because this is... somehow not considered plate iron stuff. Now that is definitely something that I would like to keep in my inventory. Silver longsword, that is going to be useful later. And sure, let's go ahead and pick that up. Let's rest here. Now if you noticed, my character was able to sleep even through all the enemies outside. Now comes the real challenge. It's fighting that skeleton up there. Okay, some of these guys actually do in fight. Okay, this guy's gonna chase me around. This is where I stand a chance of dying right off the bat. Wait a minute. Yep, I'm dead. Let's go ahead and retry that. And when it initially loads, it will give you, yeah, stuff like this. So the Unity Engine actually makes like a ton of changes. I'll let these two guys fight it out. How is this going? Giant bat died. Time for you to die then. And we are almost dead. I don't know if I'm successfully hitting him from that distance, but yeah, I am. Get dead again. So the bad part about enemies in this game is that they do not get stuck around corners. So yeah, here's my strategy right now. I'll go ahead and bait these two guys into fighting each other, and once that happens, I'm gonna run right for this thing here and hit the lever. Avoid the skeleton altogether. Just the way it's supposed to be. If you can't face the skeleton right now, no need to face it. So you can see that the skeleton's right down there, and I can hear the monsters, but I'm still asleep. And that's the result of having trouble remaining a vegan load. So you can actually rest anywhere. It's a boom. It's a boom. And the exit is up ahead. But there is like a rat in the way. Come on. You can kite, so can I. I learned recently that tactic is called kiting. There's another skeleton up ahead that we do not want to fight. We're just gonna open this door, fight the... yeah. These creatures now infight among each other. Whoa, that was easy. Okay, big tooth, and I hear a rat, but I don't see any. Figures seem to form the shadows. Alright, I'm getting out. Across a well-trod path, a bird calls nearby. I like the fact that they don't just disappear right off the bat, like they used to. And I like how my armor clinks all over the place since I'm wearing chain. This is apparently chain somehow. I don't really know how chain fits. But yeah, I've got like plentiful loot and an amazing dagger with me. A good start if I say so myself. Although my magic probably needs a little bit of work, because let me see something here. How do I open the spell menu? Do I really have to spellbook? Yeah. Okay, shock, damage, health. 1 plus 1 per 1 level. Okay, that's like the duration chance. 1 plus 1 plus 1 per levels. Magnitude 1 to 20 plus 1 to 4 plus per 1 level. Causes target's health to be damaged. Target will lose 1 to 20 points of health every round. Plus 1 to 4 points of health for every 1 levels of the caster. So basically we need to upgrade ourselves to make this more powerful. Chameleon, alright. Makes target very difficult to see. Target will remain so for 3 rounds plus 1 round. For every 1 level of caster, if target attacks something, chameleon spell is supported. I see. Slow fall. Causes target to fall at half the natural rate, greatly reducing damage. After being cast, spell will remain active for 3 rounds plus 1 round for every 1 level of caster and will trigger when target starts to fall. With that having been done, let us go ahead and travel to... where should we travel? Daggerfall, perhaps? Daggerfall? Makes the most sense, I suppose. We'll just go there, hold up in a tavern and wait for... well, for the instructions from the Empire, essentially. Yes, let us go to Daggerfall. Trip will cost us. We're gonna be traveling on foot. We got ships don't travel on land. It's going to cost us 40 gold. Thankfully, we did get plenty of loot. I mean, the king and our own savings would have been squandered away just by the travel alone. And we are now entering Daggerfall. Every time we enter a new city for the first time, things seem a little, well, slow. The game loads and everything. And look at that sky, my god. Even despite of the fact that I've turned on palatization for all of this, it looks, whew, stunning. I can't wait to see these guys in like the actual game itself. Bulletin board, I wonder what this says. For crimes against Daggerfall, Quakria is the sworn enemy of King Gothred. Huh, that was literally my previous home. I don't know what I'm gonna call home this time around. Maybe Medivia, yeah, who knows. But yeah, that was that for this. My first attempt, I knew that the skeleton was going to be challenged because I'm not supposed to be able to take on skeletons right now anyway. So yeah, I took the opportunity when it presented itself and the bat and the skeleton were busy fighting each other, and I ran, because that is practically the only thing that a person like us can do at this point. We are a very underpowered mage, and our attacks, even despite the fact that we're using an ebony dagger, will not be hitting the skeleton. Maybe as a rogue in my next playthrough I could try to damage it more, but yeah, here we are. Interesting. So with that being said, I'm excited for this next playthrough, even though I'm pretty sure that I'll be burnt out by the end of it. But these guys now have like different skins, which is nice. But one of the things that I don't really understand is why everybody appears so dark all the time. Like, unless they're standing directly next to a light, they do appear very dark, and I can't really stay outside during the night, otherwise ghosts will attack me. And I'm yet to find any spells to avoid them. So the next target is going to be joining a temple, and the one after that will be, well, joining a mage's guild essentially. Or maybe vice versa, who knows really. Maybe mage's guild first and then the temples. So with that being said, let us go ahead and actually sell some of our stuff off at the general store. Instance and soft music soothing nerves as you cross the threshold. That is a good sign. That means that this shop is going to fetch us a good price. Actually, let us go ahead and look for a armory instead. Now, I'll be doing all of that off screen, so you guys don't really need to bother about that. But as for this video, this is it. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. I'm going to make sure that this is an unedited cut, including all of my failures concerning getting across the skeleton and everything, just so that it remains, well, a more natural in its essence. Further videos down the line, though, I will be cutting out my failures. So, until then, take care. Oh yeah, just notice how I do not have any magic points right now. I cannot cast any magic because I'm out in the daylight. That is amazing. But as soon as I step into a store, I'll probably get all of my magic back. So, yeah. So, until next time, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.